गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 10, प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री। सी चिल्ड्रन, इन 6th स्टैंडर्ड ऑलरेडी यू ड्रॉन लाइन सेगमेंट ऑफ गिवन लेंथ, परपेंडिकुलर लाइंस, एंगल्स, एंगल बाइसेक्टर, सर्कल्स एक्सेट्रा। इन 7th स्टैंडर्ड वी विल ड्रॉ पैरेलल लाइंस एंड ट्राइंगल्स यूजिंग रूलर एंड कंपास। हियर फर्स्ट वी विल ड्रॉ पैरेलल लाइंस। सी चिल्ड्रन, चैप्टर नंबर 10, प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री। पॉइंट नंबर 1, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अ लाइन पैरेलल टू अ गिवन लाइन थ्रू अ पॉइंट नॉट ऑन द लाइन। फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस पॉइंट। इन दिस पॉइंट वन लाइन इज गिवन टू अस एंड वन पॉइंट इज ऑल्सो गिवन टू अस, बट दिस पॉइंट इज नॉट ऑन द गिवन लाइन। मीन्स अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस पॉइंट वन लाइन इज गिवन टू अस एंड वन पॉइंट इज गिवन टू अस एंड दिस पॉइंट इज नॉट ऑन द गिवन लाइन। Now using ruler and compass, we have to draw a new line. This is the new line. This is the new line. Means using ruler and compass, we have to draw a new line which is passing through a given point and parallel to a given line. Means we have to draw a new line which is parallel to a given line and passing through the given point. And note that given point is not on the given line. This construction we have to do using ruler and compass. And this construction I can explain with the help of one example. Example number 1. See here, exercise 10.1, example number 1. Draw a line, say AB, take a point C, outside it, through C, draw a line parallel to AB, using ruler and compass only. Means in this construction, one line AB is given to us. See here, this line AB is given to us and one point C outside is also given to us, but point C is not on the line AB. This is the line AB. Means line AB is given to us, point C is also given to us, but point C is not on the line AB. Now using ruler and compass, we have to draw new lines. This is the new line. Using ruler and compass, we have to draw a new line in such a way that it is parallel to line AB and passing through point C. This construction we have to draw. So this rough construction I explained to you. Now we will draw actual construction. See children, here we will draw actual construction. And then we can write steps also. How we can write steps? Means whatever we will do in construction or whatever we drawn in construction, that we have to write in words in steps. So how to write steps, that everybody know now. Now how to write steps simultaneously, I can explain also. Now construction. See here, to draw construction, first I will explain to you ruler and compass. See, this is the ruler and this is the compass. In compass, this is the metal line and this is the pencil line. Here chalk is available, but we will consider it is pencil line. So this is the compass, it is the metal line and it is the pencil line. Now we will draw construction. See children, draw a line, say AB, take a point C outside it. So first we will take any line AB and take any point C outside of the line AB. So step number 1. In step 1, I will draw a one line AB. In step 1, I will draw one line AB. I am drawing line AB. See here, I drawn line AB. Here point A and here point B. And I marked point C outside of line AB. See here, what I done here? I drawn a line AB and mark point C outside to it. So this same we have to write in step 1. See here, take a line AB and a point C outside of line AB. See, I take line AB and point C outside of line AB. Now step number 2. In step 2, take any point D. Take any point D on line AB. Take any point D on line AB and join point C and D. Point C and D we have to join using ruler. See here. What I done here, in step 2, take any point D on line AB and join point D and C. So this is step 2. See here, take any point D on line AB and join points D and C. Means whatever you do or whatever you drawn in construction, that same you have to write in words in step number 2. Now, step number 3. In step number 3, keep metal line on point D. Keep metal line on point D and open compass. This opening compass, it is known as radius. See, if we draw the circle in this such a way that if we draw the circle, then this is what? Radius. This is radius. So keep metal line on D and draw one arc. Keep metal line on D and draw one arc. And mark point E here and mark point F here. And mark point F here. What I done here? Keep metal line on D and draw one arc. And here mark point E and here mark point F. This is arc. A-R-C arc. This is arc. Keep metal and on D, draw one arc and mark point E and mark point F. Now this same we have to write, in step number 3. See here, I keep metal and on D, so D is the center. So with D as center and any convenient radius means this opening length. If we draw the circle, see here, if we draw the circle, then this point D is the center and this is what? Here D is the center and this is what? Radius. See, with D, here point D will come and if I draw the circle, see, if I draw the circle, so D is the center and this is the radius. So, with D as a center and any convenient radius, draw one arc which cut line AB at point E and line segment CD at point F. With D as a center, draw one arc which cut line AB at point E and line segment CD at point F. So step 3. With D as a center and any convenient radius, draw an arc which cut line AB at point E and line segment CD at point F. So this is the step number 3. Now step number 4. Now this radius you cannot change. Now keep metal line on C. See, with D center whatever radius with us, that radius you cannot change. And with keep metal line on C and draw one arc. Keep metal line on C and draw one arc. This is arc. What I done here? Keep metal line on C and draw one arc. And mark here point G. Here point G. Now see, now I will speak step number 4. With keep metal line on C and I drawn one arc. Now see here, with C as a center, with C as a center and same radius in step 3. See this radius not change. So with C as a center and same radius in step 3. Draw one arc which cut line segment CD at point G. See here, with C as a center and same radius in step 3, draw an arc which cut line segment CD at point G. With C as center, draw one arc which cut a previous, which cut a line segment CD at point G. Now step number 5. In step number 5, we have to measure distance EF. So to measure distance EF, keep metal end on E and pencil end you can keep on F. Pencil end you can keep on F. So see here, in step number 5, we will measure distance EF. So metal end we can keep at point E and pencil end we can keep on point F. So this is the distance EF. So what is the step 5? See, step 5 I will speak. Keep metal end on point E and pencil end on point F and measure the distance EF. So we measure the distance here. So this is the step 5. Now you cannot change this distance. Now step number 6. You cannot change this distance and keep metal line on G and draw one arc. You cannot change EF distance and keep metal line on G and draw one arc, which cut a previous arc at point H. What I done here, I keep metal line on G and draw one arc and mark point H here. Now I will speak step. See here, with G as a center and distance EF as a radius, draw one arc which cut previous arc at point H. With G as a center, again I am explaining, with G as a center and distance EF as a radius, draw one arc which cut previous arc at point H. So this is the step number 6. Now step number 7. In step number 7, this point C and point H we have to join. Now I am joining point C and point H. See here, I am joining point C and H. So last step, join point C and H, and here we can mark point X and here we can mark point Y. Join point C and H, mark point X and point Y. So this is the line XY. Now see children, here angle CDB and angle DCH means CDB and angle DCH both are alternate interior angles, and already we know that alternate interior angles are equal. So line XY and line AB both are parallel to each other. So line XY is the required line which is parallel to line AB and passing through the point C, and note that point C is not on the line AB. So this is the normal explanation how to construct a parallel line. I hope you can understand this. Thank you.